Like Berhard said, everything is golden.
Everything is golden. Facts.
Three.
Yeah, yeah.
Two. One. Go.
Yo, what's going on? Irvin Felix Sean with the Fitness Journals, Team No Weight Machines, and we got my boy right here, man.
Peace out.
Golden Arms. Yo, this dude is motivation to me, man. Real talk. Real talk. People like my man's right here. How old are you, bro?
45.
45. No excuses, man. Yo, tell him, man. Like, you, this is a lifestyle. 45,
yeah.
At my age, I'm 26. This is kind of something that's supposed to be.
Yeah.
But as you get older, more responsibility,
yeah,
you know, we make excuses for things. Talk to us, man.
It's tough, you know, life, working, you know, I drive 18 wheelers, you know, most people know that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a car hauler, you know, the trucks, you see all the cars on them, so I'll be gone, man. You know, sometimes I'll be at the truck stop and I'll be like, yo, I gotta sleep at the truck stop. I drop down and just give 1,000 push-ups, just bang it out. Like, it's no excuses, man, you know? People like, you a truck driver, why you ain't got a gut? And why you your face ain't
I'm about
all
to say the typical,
out?
Like, the yeah. stereotype.
Why your ass crack ain't hanging out your underwear, you know? Nah, man, because, you know, I'm about that life. Like, you know, this is a lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
This ain't a hobby.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So I'm 45, and I always told myself in my 20s, I want to be 75 doing this at least the same rep counts.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, that's my goal.
Mm-hmm.
To be 90 years old and could drop down and do 50 push-ups, you know?
That's your goal right there,
that's
man.
My goal, so.
Up to this point right now, because you said from your 20s, so
yeah.
Right now what you're doing, this is not new to you.
Nah.
In your 20s, that mentality was something that you already established,
right.
And have you deviated from it from your 20s to now?
Nah, what I've done is I've kind of enhanced the whole situation.
You enhanced it?
Because I never was in a diet. I just now got into diet like 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I started eating more healthy. Because when you're young, my mind frame is I can eat whatever I want because I work out.
Of course.
I can eat whatever I want because I work
good.
Out.
Yeah.
It works until you hit a certain age.
Yeah.
When you hit that certain age, you start hitting that 35 and up. It's like, okay, I'm feeling a little sluggish. I'm a little sleepy more. I'm getting more tired. I got a little more aches and pains. So, you know, the diet has a lot to do with that, you know? Diet has a lot to do with it, so
wisdom, with years comes that wisdom, and it seems like that's what happened.
So, I drink nothing but water. I eat a lot of vegetables and a lot of fruits, more than anything. Like, I don't eat junk food. I barely even cheat. Like, I don't even, you know, I'm not even interested in cheating, like having an airhead or something, Twizzlers or something. It's not happening. Like, I'm over it. I did that all my life, you know, my young youth. Now I just want to change and switch over, you know?
That makes sense. And it's like, once you've been through that stage and you know what it presents to you, it's like, hey, honestly, I mean, I'm 26, but I still kind of feel that way now. Like, that thought, that process is developing just by knowing how I feel and how I perform, how I look. I know, like, I was raised vegan.
Yeah.
I went, started doing my own thing, eating whatever. Not that anything in here, like, I chose that I wanted to eat meat.
Mm-hmm.
But after now, I did feel.
Yeah, but you was eating that good meat in when you was growing up.
Yeah, Asia, I was over in Asia. Yeah.
Places.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's different.
Absolutely, like, that's true.
I only been vegan, September will be a year.
Okay.
This September will be 1 year I've been vegan, so I'm loving it. I don't have a problem with. I can smell meat. I can go to cookout. I can smell all that. It doesn't bother me. Like I'm beyond.
Was it cold turkey?
Yeah. No, actually, I went 3 years eating meat only for dinner.
Okay.
Only for dinner. So I would have, you know, peanut butter and jelly sandwich, almond butter and jelly sandwiches for lunch. I would have my oatmeal for breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and then for dinner I would have more vegetables. You know, some wild rice. And I have a small portion of meat.
Mm-hmm.
This went on for like 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally the last year, I'm almost on a year now, I said, you know what? I don't need the meat no more. I might as well just let it go, you know?
So it was at that point, it was just like, at that decision point, it's like after doing that, it was almost, I'm not missing out now. I don't feel like I'm missing anything
anymore. It was inevitable. It was coming. Like, you know what I mean? I said, what am I doing this for? I might as well, it's just time to rock out.
So what is it like going to, because a lot of the concern that people have going out to eat or going out on family, how do you deal with that?
Well, initially, at first, it was rough because, you know, I got the family, the kids, so we going out and everybody knows as soon as we sit down and they hand us the menus, my whole family's looking at me like,
what are you going to do?
Here we go again that. Like, you know what I mean? So I'm like, all right, I'm going to figure this out. So now I got my family, we come in as a team now, and we always, like, before we go, we prepared. We look at the menu, what can dad eat? What can I eat? What can I do? How can I work with them? What can they do for me? So usually now these people are used to me. These restaurants, they're used to me. When I walk in, now they say, okay, this guy, we already know, don't cook his food in butter. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We know what we can offer him. And, you know, basically I know what I can order and what I can't now.
Absolutely.
It's just experience.
Absolutely.
Yep.
So, hey, I'm sure people have, you've heard people talk about that, like, oh, going out, it's too much of a hassle.
Yeah.
And being locked inside for the past couple months,
right,
people are like, oh, well, man, I mean, you can't go out and eat, period, now. Yeah. It's like, you, unless you go and do your pickup thing or
pick
whatever.
Pickup thing, yeah.
But you have to think a little bit, you got to prepare a little bit.
Yeah,
and like you said, ahead of time, you prepare ahead of time before you do that.
Yeah.
So what does a typical, now like you've taken a breakfast, lunch, and dinner, what was a typical on the go? Because you're on the go.
Yeah,
right?
On the go.
What does that look like for you?
Okay, like a typical work day?
Okay. Like from what you eat to how you work out.
I pack my bag. So my lunch bag consists of, because I leave like midnight, 1 a.m. sometime.
Okay.
You know, that's, you could, anytime during the week, you could, if you need to holler at me, I'm up in the middle of the night.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Just give you a heads up, I'm up. He's like, yo, what you doing? Pardon the language. What is you doing up? Man, I'm about to drop these cars off, man. But anyway, getting back to the point, I pack my breakfast. So usually I got my oatmeal in my thermos, okay? I sprinkle a little cinnamon in it. You know, I put a little sea moss in it, and I put a little turmeric in it, stir it up. Now it's going to stay warm, right? I keep that with me, and I'll bring a box of raisins, a banana, an apple, you know, and I'll have some, like, coconut-based yogurt, you know, coconut milk based yogurt, and I have that in my bag for breakfast. So when I hit the road, you know, like I said, it's the middle of the night, I won't eat breakfast till about 5 a.m. so about 5 a.m. I start eating that, boom. So about noontime, what else I got in my bag is I have some almond butter and jelly sandwiches with banana spread on it, you know what I'm saying, on the Ezekiel bread. So I'll have that for lunch. I have some veggie chips, you know, because that's kind of like cheating to me.
Yeah, yeah, it's a snack.
It's the healthiest chips I can find.
Yeah,
it's with my sandwiches. So I have some veggie chips, and I'll have some Ziploc berries, some raspberries, strawberries, and some blackberries and blueberries. So I'll have that for lunch. You know, and mind you, I'm sipping on three liters of alkaline water a day.
Okay.
So, you know, I got two big bottles, a liter and a half. So by the time my day is over, those bottles are gone. So at any given time, I'm sipping water, you know? And then when I get home, dinner is usually consists of like all sorts of vegetables. It could be like avocado, it could be zucchini, it could be asparagus, sometimes a little broccoli. I'm a little weary about broccoli, but you know, it is what it is, you know? And some carrots, and wild rice, quinoa, you know, whichever day it is. Some beans, of course, Gonzaga beans, if I'm pronouncing it right. Pinto beans, black beans, kidney beans. Every day is different what kind of beans I have, of course. And, you know, before that I have a salad, which consists of red onions, hemp seed, you know, spinach salad. I'll have avocado in it, of course. A touch of Italian. Just a touch. You don't want OD on the dressing.
Something light.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, Nathan, how you doing? And that's basically it, you know what I mean? So that's basically kind of like my day. You know, of course, I'll have some coconut water with my dinner because I had regular water all day. And that's how I do it. That's my day eating, man.
It's not crazy. It's just like you become adapted. You become, by planning. It's not something that overnight you just know this is what I'm gonna eat and that's it.
Yeah,
it's over time and you adapted
and listen, it's not easy. You putting a lot of work in the kitchen, man. Like, I gotta cut up my fruits and stuff, put them in Ziploc bags to prepare to take the next morning. Like, you gotta prepare for all this stuff, like even juicing beets and stuff like that. Like, that's a lot of work you put in the kitchen, man. Like,
so planning is important.
You constantly find yourself in the kitchen a lot, man. You at the pull-up bar or you in the kitchen, dicing up, son. It's not easy, man.
Is it some worth it, though?
Yeah, definitely worth it.
I mean, look at my boy, man.
Definitely worth it.
And how's the energy? The energy level?
Energy is great. Energy is great, man. I ain't never lost energy, bro. I'm full of it, actually.
Full energy.
Full of it.
And like you said, the goal is like getting, so thinking with the end in mind, getting to that 70, that 80,
right.
that 90.
Right.
So give just everything you gave is advice, but like,
yeah.
If this is it, I know there's no golden rule, but like something that's really been important in helping you in your journey. Up to this point, because your journey's still going.
What's been helping me is just aging and watching my kids age. And I got a 19-year-old in college, and I got a 14-year-old getting ready to go to high school. And it's just, I want to be able to be here and be able to play with my grandchildren and be healthy,
mm-hmm.
not on a cane, not on medication. You know what I'm saying? I want to grow old and still be strong, fit, and be able to see things and experience things and be able to join in and not be sitting in a wheelchair laughing and waiting. You know what I mean? I want to be involved.
You want to be involved.
Yeah.
Not letting the last of your life pass you by.
That's right. That's right. Live my life to the fullest, man.
There you go. That's so, right. Yo, Instagram, YouTube.
Instagram is GoldenArms1. GoldenArms number one. And the YouTube is Golden Arms Workouts, you know what I mean? And you know, I gotta put some work on the YouTube, but it's just something light for now.
For sure.
I haven't been putting any time in it, honestly. But it's there, and I'm gonna work on that. But the Instagram, definitely Golden Arms One.
There you go. So, yo, once again, man, it's people like my boy right here. You guys use that, draw that energy, get that energy from there.
Yes, sir.
And that's how we do it. It's a community. Like I said, man, I'm inspired. My goal is not, that's why people ask, oh, are you using roids? Nah, never have. Yeah, my thing is getting to the level like this and keep going and going and going. It's a lifestyle. It's not something, I'm not trying to get on stage and win money. Nothing's wrong with that, but that's not my goal.
Can I say one thing?
Yeah, definitely.
Listen carefully. We are not bodybuilders. We are not perfect. My legs, oh yeah, I got little legs, but I tell you one thing, I can squat with you.
Facts,
bro. If I wanted to squat and put weights on my back, I could do that with you.
Me too.
My leg, take a look at my legs. Yeah, they skinny, take a look. I gotta work on them.
Nah, but he got legs though, man.
My upper body's bigger. Because when I was young, it was all about upper body when we was young.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up in the early 90s, 80s. We didn't do legs, you know, so I'm jumping on it late. So. Just want you guys to know, it's never too late. My legs are gonna get right.
That's a fact. There you go.
Because I'm working on it.
That's a fact.
It's called consistency.
That's a fact.
I'm in the middle of consistency.
There you go.
So don't judge.
There you go. In the middle of consistency.
Yeah,
I like that. In the middle of consistency.
Right.
And that's a fact. It's like, yo, just because you're not where you wanna be, if you know that's where you wanna go, guess what? You put in the work, and that will show. So, like I said.
So if they say, yo, man, Golden Arms need to work on his legs. Yeah, I am. Trust me.
There you go. So,
I am.
He working, I'm working on it,
that's
all
right.
of us working on it. That's a fact. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. Look, any questions you guys got, drop it in the comment section below, and definitely go and support the homie, man.
Golden legs coming soon.
Golden legs, there we go. We out of here. Health is wealth. Get money. It's always a warm-up.
Peace.